Hello, dear listener, dear viewer. My name is Mpulu Kiluruma Mokgobe, bringing you yet another exciting and impactful episode of Mokgobe's Nuggets of Wisdom podcast. Today, I'm going to deal with the question of why winners never quit and quitters never win. I had the privilege recently of attending a seminar in which the keynote speaker was a certain Lisa Nichols. Lisa Nichols is one of the foremost motivational speakers in the world, and she owns a company called Motivating the Masses. So I thought about it and I went deeper into it and want to go a little bit further into the psychology of why winners never quit and quitters never win. Number one, the reason why winners never quit is because they know that normally when they are tempted to quit, it's because they've come across a stumbling block or a disturbance of some kind. So they are very smart. They realize that the setback that they are encountering is in fact a setup. It's a step up to a setup. In other words, your setback becomes a step up to a setup. So that's one of the nuggets of wisdom on that point. Your setback becomes a step up for a setup for greater success and greater achievement. Number two, people normally quit because they see others doing great things, much greater than them. For instance, the people who may have completed high school or university at the same time as you. You may see some of them going a lot further in life and you may say, it's a hopeless effort. Why should I even bother? Sometimes it's even sad to see people who are not even as smart as you are excelling in life, doing much better. But if you're a real winner, you'll remind yourself that in the university of life, the university of life is actually a university of adversity. And in that university, there are different courses and different faculties for different people. So whatever somebody else is doing doesn't matter, should not bother you. Focus on your race, develop your goals, develop your targets for yourself and ignore other people. Number three, every challenge has many permutations, angles from which to tackle it. There's a popular saying that there are nine ways to skin a cat. Going beyond the cat, the idea is that there's always a multiplicity of approaches. There are many angles from which to look at a problem. Take a look or think about a Rubik's Cube, for instance. There are so many permutations, so many variations when you are playing with that cube to eventually get to the solution. So that is the thinking and the psychology of winners. That is why winners never quit and quitters never win. One of the reasons. Number four, there is precedent. Whenever you have a problem, know that there's a precedent to that problem. I come from a background of law, where I'm a practicing lawyer at the moment. We work through precedents. There's a law of stare decisis, where you look at what another court said on the same matter previously. Similarly, when we deal with winning and not quitting, there's always a precedent for whatever obstacle you're encountering. The Bible will give you some wisdom as to how to tackle that problem. But speaking of the Bible, it says that there's wisdom in multiple of counsels. In other words, there's wisdom in looking for advice from different people and so on. And in this day of Google, in this day of YouTube, there's always somebody who has tackled that problem before. Your solution is out there waiting for you to find it. Number five, winners are able to come up out of their comfort zone. Part of the reason that quitters quit and they never win is because they are not prepared to get out of their comfort zone. Challenge yourself, dear listener, dear viewer, to get not only out of your comfort zone, but to completely get the comfort zone out of you. Sometimes you get out of your comfort zone, but you have that comfort zone within you. So you have to distance yourself from your comfort zone. And I like the expression, thinking outside the box. Not only should you think outside the box, you must kick the box altogether and get rid of it. You don't need it. So number six, the reason why winners never quit and quitters never win is that winners know that by quitting, they are bringing about their own demise. They are actually giving permission to the naysayers, to the doomsayers, to even their competitors, to even their enemies to celebrate. So if you are a winner, you won't give your enemies an opportunity to celebrate. So you'll persist, you'll persevere, and overcome the challenges. The number seven reason why winners never quit and quitters never win is that life will always give you lemons. Before life can give you oranges, you have to first deal with lemons. So you have to have the mentality of how do I turn these lemons into lemonade? How do I convert them into something positive, something that can work for me and use it as a setup for a greater achievement? In other words, that obstacle and that difficulty, as I explained in an earlier nugget, is a way to your greater success. So though a greater success, similarly, those lemons are your way to get to your lemonade and to get eventually to your oranges. So learn to accept your layers before you get to your ratio. This one is number 8. Learn to accept your layer before you get to your ratio. Some of you might know the story in the Bible of Jacob. Jacob was very deceitful. He went and stayed with his with his uncle called Laban, and then he got into an agreement that he'll work for 7 years for a beautiful woman called Rachel. Cutting the long story short, that deceitful uncle swapped the brides or in the middle of the night, and Jacob ended up with Leah. My point here is that learn to live with your Leah. What Jacob did is stayed with Leah for 7 years before he worked for 7 years to get his Rachel. So similarly, success-minded people, and that's why winners never quit and quitters never win, is they know that eventually they'll get to their ratio if they put the time, if they put the effort, and they keep going. Number 9, I say to myself whenever I have a difficulty, keep trying, Mom. Mom is my nickname. Keep trying, keep moving, keep going. So similarly, I look for things that will empower me, that will get me to overcome those hurdles. Martin Luther King Jr. said, if you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. But whatever you do, for God's sake, whatever you do, keep moving. So the idea is that make those bite-sized steps towards success. I mean, people often, I've had people asking a rhetorical question, how many bites does it take to eat an elephant? The answer is, I don't know, but at least one bite at a time. Eventually, you'll eat that elephant. You'll get done with it. If you look at all our heroes in life, whether it's Nelson Mandela, whether it's David, whether it's Jeremiah, whether it's Esther in the Bible, they persevered. They persisted. That's why we remember them. That's why we are mentioning their names. So if you want to be remembered, persist and overcome that challenge. Number 10, you are rewarded in life not because of what you start, but because of what you finish. Results trump effort each and every time. I keep saying to my group, I keep saying to my team at work, results trump effort. Unfortunately, you can't get results without effort, but ultimately you will be judged based on your results, not so much on your effort. Because with effort, you can stop when you are 99% to the finish line, but nobody's going to remember that. You have to push right across so that you get to 100% and you get to the finish line. That is why winners, ladies and gentlemen, never quit, and quitters never win. They appreciate these things, they understand them. Let me give you number 10. This is the number 10 nugget of wisdom as to why winners never quit and quitters never win. And this was said by the great statesman, Winston Churchill. So I want to leave you with a quotation from Winston Churchill. He said, this is the lesson: never give in, never give in, never, 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 never in anything, nothing great or small, large or petty, never give in except to convictions of honor and good sense. The only time you give up is when you have convictions of honor and good sense. For instance, when it's really clear beyond all doubt that maybe you are looking for something that you will never get. I'll give you an example. It's like me, a short guy like this, trying to beat Michael Jordan at basketball. When it's very clear that the result I want is unachievable, it's outside the realm of reality, and then convictions of honor and good sense will say, no, this is the time to quit. So that in a nutshell is the top 10 nuggets of why winners never quit and quitters never win. Please, dear listener, like what you're hearing, and more importantly, subscribe to this channel. It was a privilege and an honor to share with you. Thank you.